Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with another Shopify how-to video. And in this video, we will learn how to make transparent and sticky header in DOM theme. So after implementing this tutorial, you will have your header like this, which will be transparent. And when you scroll down, it will be sticky and change its color to white. Cool, right? Also, you will have option in your customize to disable this feature by just checking it out. So if you go to customize and click on header, you will have an option to disable the transparent header, and you can also have you will also have option to disable the sticky header. By default, that's how the header of DOM theme looks like. So that's the default header of DOM theme. When you scroll it down, it's not sticky, but when you scroll up, it shows up. And after implementing this tutorial, you'll have it like this. So if you want to learn, please stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Comment on the video below if you have any confusion or questions. And let's just get into the backend to implement the code. So guys, that's the tutorial which I'll be following. I'll put the link in the video description so you guys can have all of the codes. Now just let's go back to the admin and activate the fresh DOM theme, which I have already installed. Click on online store. So that's the DOM theme which already have transparent header, which I showed you guys. So I prepared all the code in order to preview you guys how it will look. And that's the fresh copy of DOM which I added just 12 minutes ago. Okay, now I'm going to publish it so we can start from the scratch. Click on publish. And here we go. Now I have the fresh DOM theme activated. Now I'm going to click on actions and then edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have the duplicate version saved. So click on duplicate and save your current state of the theme. So because we'll be doing a lot of code edits, and if you miss anything, miss any step or mistakenly delete any other line, you can easily revert it back. Okay, now let's hit refresh, and that's how our store is now with the default header. So when you scroll down, it's not sticky, and when you scroll up, it's sticky. Now we'll make it to transform like this. Okay, I'm going to close this one and just start work on the code. I'm going to click on edit code. Close this window as well. Okay, now our first step is to go to header.liquid and delete everything which is between these tags. So that's how your code will look like, and you will have to delete all of it from top to bottom. Okay, so I'm going to go to header.liquid and search for JavaScript. Here we go. So that's our code, and I'm going to delete out everything till and JavaScript. So that's all of the code which is currently added by default in DOM theme, which is responsible to make the header sticky, but it's not ideal sticky header which we need. So I'm going to delete all this code and hit save. Okay, now let's go back to our article and scroll down. Now we need to add the following code to our global.js file. I'm going to search for global.js. So that's the file. Click on that. Scroll down to the bottom. That's the end of the file. Add a line break and copy this code. And paste it. Okay, now hit refresh. Hit save. before hitting refresh, and then go back to your store and hit refresh. And now when you scroll down, you have your header sticky. So previously when you were scrolling down, it wasn't sticky. Now we have it. Now we will do the transparent header thing, and we will add option in customize to change icon's color and to change our header background color by editing the customize options. Okay. Now we'll go in theme.liquid file and replace this code with this code. Okay, let's go to our theme.liquid. There's the file. I'm going to search for this code. Oops. Okay, here's our code. And replace it with this one. Okay, done. Hit save. Now let's go to our next step, which is replacing code in header.liquid. So we will replace the header tag, which looks like this, with the following code. Replace this code with this code. Okay, now let's search for it. In our header.liquid, go to header.liquid, search for this code. Okay, here we see this code. Now I'm going to replace it with this. Replace this, paste the code, hit save, and go back to our tutorial again. Now we will update the detailed stack within header.liquid file. So that's the code which we'll be replacing with the following code. Okay, now I'm going to search it. So here's our code. Yep. Summary class header. So these are the two lines which I'm going to replace with this code here. So just copy the code and paste it here. Okay, hit save again. Go back to the tutorial and follow one more step, which is in the same file. Now we'll be replacing details model tag. Now search for this code in the same file. And replace it with the following code. Okay, hit save. Now go back to the tutorial and just two more snippets which we need to add to complete our tutorial, and we will add this code above schema tag. So all of these changes are in header.liquid file. Make sure to read the main heading before replacing the code. And okay, now we will add this code above our schema tag. We'll scroll down to the bottom. So that's all of our schema tag, which is starting from here, as you can see, schema. I'm going to paste this code here above our schema. So you can see this line, if request.pageType is equal to index. We'll add this code above. I'll paste the code. Hit refresh, hit save. Sorry about that. Okay, hit save. And then finally, we will add our schema code below the current schema tag, which will add option in customize section. Okay. So I'm going to copy this code and add this code above our image picker. scroll down. So here's our code, and we need to add our code here. Make sure not to delete any commas here. It's really important for that. And do not mistake anything. Keep watching and paste our code here. Okay, now hit refresh. Oh, sorry. Hit save again. And now let's go back to your website and now finally hit refresh. We are not seeing anything because we'll have to enable this option by going to our customize. So I'm going to go back to the backend. Click on online store. Click on customize. And from there, click on header. And here we have option to enable our transparent header and enable our sticky header. So our sticky header is already enabled. We'll just enable our transparent header. And here we go. Our transparent header is showing up. We can change the icons color here. So these are the icons which can be controlled from here. We can change the color from here. So just click on that and change color to see it updated. Okay, I'm going to make it white. Perfect. Now hit save. Go back to the home page and hit refresh. And here we go. As you can see, our menu text color and the icon color is white, but when we scroll down, it's transformed again to black. So guys, the code which we added for transparent header is only for the home page. It's not gonna work if you go to any of the inner page. So for example, if I click on my catalog and go to the new collection page, you can see that it's sticky, but it's not transparent header. But if you want this feature to enable on inner pages as well, you can amend, you can change code a little to make it appear on all of the pages, which can happen from this code. So the code which we copied from here, the code which we added above schema, has this if check. So it's checking if the template is indexed. You can simply remove this code. Template is equal to index and. So if you remove this code, hit save. And now if I go back to my store and to my collection page, which is the inner page of my website, and hit refresh, my transparent header will come back. It's looking a little weird because I don't have any top picture on my collection page, but you might have it on the top. So it will look good if you have that kind of setup. And you can easily get it back if you just want it on the home page. So template is equal to index and it's safe. Now it will only be applied to your home page. Done. Okay guys, so that's it for the tutorial. If you guys liked it, don't forget to comment, ask questions if you need more clarification and if it's not working for you or your theme. And if you want any help with Shopify customization, WordPress web design and development, we can help you with that. Just contact us on info@websandspro.com. And until next video, have a great day.